Hi, this is Anne with SVG Cut File, and today I'm going to show you how to use glyphs and special characters that come with your fonts in Cricut Design Space, and this is for a Mac. This is not going to work on PC because it uses Fontbook, which is only available on Mac. All right, let's get started. All right, first I want to show you an example of what I mean by font glyphs. This is a version of Andalusia font. That's a font that's available on font bundles, and I do have the link in my description if you want to purchase that and follow along. It's not my font, but it's one of the most beautiful out there in my opinion. So this is what happens if you just type with the Andalusia font. But if you choose to use the glyphs that come with this font, you can really end up with something amazing. And here's what the font looks like with the glyphs being used. Now, I did want to mention that if you want to follow along, you'll need to find a font that actually has glyphs included. Not every font has that. It's something that the designer adds to a font. So I'm going to start out with this version, and I'm just going to recreate this to show you how to use these beautiful glyphs. So we're in Cricut Design Space, and I'm going to come over here to the text tool, and we'll just type out beautiful. I'm going to select all with Command A, and then I'll come up here to the fonts, and I'll choose System Fonts, and I'll type in Andalusia. And here it is. If you want to know how to install a font, I also have a video about that, and I'll just link it up in the card above. Okay, so when you type something like this, Design Space adds a lot of space. So let's come up here to Letter Space, and I'm just going to change this to 0. This is a little closer to what I want, but I think I'll reduce it even more. Okay, this looks nice. I'll resize it. This is a live typable font right now, but to get it to look like this, we really have to come up here to Advanced and do something. So I want to copy this and paste it first. So I'll hit Command C and Command V on my keyboard, and I'll just pull it over here. Now I'll select this one, and we'll come up here to Advanced and ungroup to letters. You'll notice there's a separate layer for every letter now. And now I can just manually use my arrow keys to move this out a little bit. I'll select these and move them in. Ooh, but not that much. I'm going to come up to my position and do just 9-0. Okay, that looks much better. Now I'll select the F and U and L and move those over a little bit. And we basically now have the same thing we have up here. All right, but let's add our cool looking glyphs in. To do that, I'm going to hit Command Spacebar, and that'll bring up the Spotlight search. And in the Spotlight search, you can just search for Fontbook. Now, once you're in Fontbook, you'll need to search for your font. So I'm going to type Andalusia up here, and here it is. I'll click on it, and then you'll see all the characters that come with this font. You can also increase or decrease the size of the characters. So I think 50 is pretty good. I can see what each of them are, but they're not overwhelming. Now, to get to the special characters included in this font, we'll have to go all the way to the bottom. That's probably not the case with every font, but it is with this one. All right, we'll start with a capital B. I'll scroll through until I find that one. Okay, here it is. Now I just click on this and copy with Command C. Then I'll come back to Design Space. I'll double click on my word to get my text back up. I'll highlight the B and then I'll paste. And it's probably going to paste something that looks pretty weird, but that's just fine. Okay, the next thing I'm looking for is this T swash. So let's go back out to Fontbook. You can Command Tab and then release, and it should bring you right back to Fontbook. And now we can scroll through these and find the lowercase T. Okay, here it is. I'll click on that and copy. Then I'll get into my text area and highlight the T and paste. And you'll see a lot of space being added because Design Space can't really tell that the end of the letter isn't right here because it technically is. So that's the kind of effect you'll get, but that's fine. Now let's look for an F. I'll copy this one and paste. All right, I'll just move this down. And now we'll grab an L. I'll choose this one. Okay, so this is looking great. Now we'll just come up to the advanced section and choose ungroup to letters, just like we did before. I'm going to click on the B and use my arrow keys to move it just a little bit outward. And if it jumps too far, you can always come up here to position and go about halfway between what you just saw. So I'm going to put this at 53. I'll click on these and then just move them over. Then I'll choose the F and move it to touch. Grab these two, hold shift, and just drag them over. And click on the L and move it until it touches. Now our text looks beautiful, custom, and hand-drawn. Now before we go to make this, we'll want to weld it. Let's select our word and change the color. I'll come up here to the colors right here. I'm going to change this to a light purple. Now you'll notice when we zoom in down here, these touching letters have a line between them. And so if you cut it right now, Cricut is going to cut right there. So you have to be careful about that. And the way to fix it is to highlight everything and then just come down here to weld. And that'll make everything into one piece where it needs to be, basically where it's touching another letter. And when you do that, you'll see that it becomes one layer. After that, all you need to do is just hit the green button and make it. All right, if you like this video, please click on the like button. And if you want to see more videos like this, you can subscribe. All right, I'll see you in the next video. Thank you.